We're going canoeing. We're going canoeing, Kyle. Yeah. What are you doing?
I'm eating.
We haven't even gone in the lake yet.
I'm hungry after unpacking my gear.
What size bag is that, Kyle?
120 liters of food.
Yeah, it is. We're finally in the water. Nice area, nice big lake. We gotta make our way. We got some pretty nice scenery. There's nice rolling hills everywhere around us. And we are headed that way in front of Kyle, basically. And then lake starts to narrow out. This is Cedar Lake. It's funny how you, if you haven't paddled for a while, you gotta get your way into it. You gotta get used to it again. So we've just stopped here. We've been paddling for maybe an hour, hour and a half tops. And stopped here at this campsite to look at the map, have a water break, and just kind of get used to the paddlings. We started out here on Cedar Lake so far. We've paddled down, up, past these little islands, and we're here. And we still got to go into Little Cedar still. I'm going to leave this shaving stick here for someone, see if... Well, I guess I'll have no way of knowing if they know what it is, but... It's nice out here. Yep. We just came into this beauty section of Little Cedar Lake, I believe. All right, so we've made it to our first portage, where it's only 275 meters. So I think this one, we're just gonna walk with our packs. Both of us at the same time, and then come back for the canoe. It's no big deal, and this is our only portage of the day. So we're gonna take it easy. It's a beautiful day already, and looking forward to getting to camp and eating some foods. Better than carrying the pack, eh?
Any day of the week. Yeah, this thing's nice. Anytime. We're gonna real quick run up the woods, try to cut some little wood real fast, and then food, dinner, a little captain and us tonight.
So lucky to find this downed pine. Gonna bust up some kindling and some fuel from it. Kyle's out there still trying to find some hardwood. I don't know if it's gonna happen or not, but it's really not that important tonight. We don't need to cook on the fire or anything like that, so we just wanna have a fire tonight. Eaters. So Kyle just got back from getting some wood. He said there's a big white pine up there that we can go get some limbs off of, so we're gonna go do that, and we need to hang a bear bag because the lights, we're losing light. But before I do that, I got some dehydrated spaghetti that I made at home before the trip. I'm gonna actually rehydrate that as we're working. So all I'm gonna do is put your food in your cup or whatever you're doing it in, and then fill up water just above the food line and let it sit while you're working or doing whatever. And in about 20 minutes, it will have plumped up. It's not ready to go yet, but it's more on its way on its rehydration process. So that's actually just gonna sit right here by this tree. And it's wood time. These pants are pretty badass. I just got back from collecting wood, and they got this pocket in here where I can slide my axe right through, and I can use both my hands to carry the wood back. So it comes out, it sticks a little bit on the way out, but. Yep. But it's not anything too hard.
A great job limbing these, Joe.
Thanks.
Ew, look at my toes are peeling.
Gross.
Already.
So everything's all set up now. We got our bear bag up, our tents up, and all that stuff. We actually went out to try to get a couple fish, but no luck. We came back to the campsite, set up our tents in the dark, cooked our food and all that stuff. So we're just kind of hanging out. I think we're going to sleep good tonight.
Is it out or out?
Okay. What do you think it is, about 7 o'clock? Oh, you're just going to crinkle the candy bar in my face. Yep. I'm saying candy bar now.
What time is it? It's like, I don't know, like 6:40.
As you can see from my swollen face, I'm awake now. I had a great sleep. There's a nice mist coming in off the lake. It's chilly enough to wear a long sleeve shirt. So that's really nice. September 5th, so... We were expecting a little bit cooler weather, but it's nice at nighttime. You get to sit by the fire and have a long sleeve shirt on and stuff. And then in the daytime, we're not too chilly. It's actually nice and warm, so it's about the perfect time. Today we have about 20 kilometers to do, and try our hand at some fishing again, because some trout in the tummy would be nice. Oh, did you see what kind?
No, couldn't tell.
You fail at life.
Hey, they hit it.
Those weren't words. Those weren't words that you just said. We're just paddling around the lake right now, casting some lines in. I got one on, like a bottom feeder. Had it at the boat and he got off, no big deal. Kyle just had one almost at the boat too, so we're using these little spoons and it's a little bit different fishing than we're used to, but we'll make the best of it and keep trying. And other words that are encouraging.
Probably, that's a rock.
That's a rock, he says.
Well, maybe. Maybe it's a stuck. It's a stuck.
It's a stuck. It's a stuck. The elusive stuck.
Oh, I got the itchy big one.
Shit.
8 days.
Camera for sure.
This is excitement right now.
Oh my god, I got something on here.
You got a lac trout. Oh, you got a walleye, dude. Straight up. Nice. Have you ever caught a walleye before?
I haven't.
Oh, watch the hook.
I'm trying to watch the dry segs.
Yeah, that's awesome, dude.
Oh yeah, check that sucker out.
Very cool.
Yeah. Nice, man, look at that thing.
I've never caught a walleye either.
Well, you know, I'm pro now.
Yeah, yeah.
Just kidding.
Pro Burley. Burley Outdoors, boys. Boys and girls. That's awesome, man. Well, starting to get annoyed. Starting to get a little pissed off at the Kyle.
That's nothing.
Okay, that is nothing.
It's a fish, though.
You're still really happy. You got a goofy-ass grin on your face.
Well, I'm goofy-looking, so.
Yep.
Not as bad-looking as you are, though.
Rainier.
What is this?
That is a smallie. It's a small smallie. I'm proud of you. This place is really nice. There's a nice waterfall behind me. Really cool.
How many times are we gonna do this?
Up and down, up and down.
On previous trips, we've had a lot of gypsy pack going on, things hanging everywhere in multiple bags, but this trip, Colin and I both decided it's better to have one bag, so I do have a little gypsy pack water bottle holder hanging off, but that's it. Everything else is self-contained. We just have our life jackets other than what we have right here, so super easy doing the portages, and I think it's the way to go from now on.
I agree. It's a lot easier for portages, you don't have crap everywhere. The other thing we've been doing too is for each day, we have the laminated map.
Mm-hmm. It's off Jeff's maps, and it's real nice because I tuck it in my life vest, and then I pull it in and out, and we can, you know, see where we're going and stuff. It's real helpful.
You're real helpful.
Yeah, you're not.
Yep. I think we're both kind of in awe right now. It's just a really beautiful morning, perfect weather. Kyle got a walleye, I got a sucker, Kyle got a bass, I got a wannabe bass.
A guppy.
About the size of my pinky finger. And it's all good, man. I'm having a good time. Second morning, we got what, 6 more days, something like that. Time is irrelevant right now. And that's partly why we come out here. No schedule, so just make it to land and eat our food, sleep, call her good. Both getting kind of hungry. We've been paddling for a couple hours now. I gotta take a pee-pee. So I think we're gonna look for one of these campsites up here that we see on our map. And take a break, eat some food and stuff. But yeah. Just paddling away. Just trying to think of something to say to the camera, you know?
Just let the nature speak for you, Joe. It does a much better job.
I agree. I tend to fumble my words, a little mush mouthy. A little stumble over the wordsy. Peace! And a couple little green frogs here. These are my favorite kind of frog. Running on the portage over to Mink Lake, and I just carried the canoe over in this one because Kyle did the last one. It's 450 meters. I had to come back for my gear. Today's been pretty nice so far. It's about 1 o'clock. Pretty uneventful, to be honest with you. Nice day, nothing crazy happened. No wind at all to speak of. Easy paddling. The sun's bright, the sun's hot. But dip my hat in the water every now and then, put it on my head, cools me down. So I don't think we have too much more to do today. Probably stop at the end of this portage and refuel on water. And we're off like a pro. So we made it to the Kiosk Lake Portage, and Kyle is feeling extra burly today, so he's gonna try and one carry the canoe and the pack as far as he can. It's a 635 meter portage, probably a medium distance portage overall, but I know I can't do it with my pack and the canoe at once, but we'll see what Kyle can do. So how was doing that in one carry?
It was perfectly fine until we got to the end.
Why?
Because we ran into one of your people, your fan club, and I could literally see your head expand, go...
Yep, that happens.
That's what happened.
All right.
We would have been at camp by 4:15.
So we're finally at our camp, day two. I was saying it was an uneventful day. And that everything was going smooth and that it was just a nice day and all that stuff, which it still is a nice day, but in our preparation for this trip and to try to do the duration that we wanted, the 8 days, we had to start at the Brent campground and come towards Kiosk Lake. And Kiosk Lake is an access point, another access point at Lake Brent is, but way more used. And Kiosk is a huge lake with road access on one side. So what happened was we wanted to get into Kiosk and get into a bay halfway down the lake so that tomorrow half of our trip down the lake would be complete and the bay would be sheltered and offer better fishing. So we did that and we went into the bay, which is huge. It is an enormous lake, and we paddled in and campsite was taken. We paddled for 2 hours in this lake in a loop, We went from this end back up here almost to the end, almost back to where we started. And tomorrow we have to go back that way down to get to the portage. One campsite we found, finally. We are exhausted. We would have been at camp 2 hours ago. It's 6 o'clock now. We started at 7 in the morning. So, anyways, we're here and we hate each other by now. It's only day two. Food. Food time.
Food?
Eventful.
Yay! Hashtag fun.
Hashtag bleh.
Hashtag balls.
So Kyle's a little bit happy now. What happened?
Well, in preparation of this trip, I went full stupid. I grabbed my alcohol stove and all the contents out of my pot, set it aside, and brought the pot because I knew Joe was going to bring his stove. When I did that, it took my spork out. So guess what I just found?
Bam!
A crappy used, I think this is for Dairy Queen brand? Maybe?
Yes, Dairy Queen, exactly.
Dairy Queen, brand. Dairy Queen sounds really good right now. Anyways, we're going to clean this up and I'll have a spoon now.
Garbage.
I'm looking so forward to sitting in this chair after like 11 hours of that canoe. My back's hurting a little bit, and I'm really looking forward to having something to rest my back on. So I think these chairs are definitely worth their weight, especially for a camping trip or for a canoe camp trip. There we go. I don't think I'm gonna move for a while.
Don't blame me.
On this trip, we're doing distance. This isn't a bushcrafty kind of trip. This is more of a get up and go kind of trip. So we're doing about 120 kilometers canoeing, portaging in 7 full days, eight days total, but 7 full days. We're hungry. We just got to camp. It's hot, super hungry, and we need to eat. So instead of getting a fire going and waiting and cooking water that way, this stove, this MSR pocket rocket, makes short work of that. So it's really good. It comes in this little container. To turn her on. I'm using a lighter. You can use a fire steel, whatever. And it'll rehydrate my meal real quick for me. When we first got to camp, I poured water in my chili. This is dehydrated chili. And it's been about a half an hour, and it's rehydrating as we're working, as we're setting up our tents, all that nonsense. So now it's just gotta get heated.
All right, chili's done. Tell me that doesn't look good. Kidney beans, mushrooms.
That's very good.
We weren't exaggerating when we said this lake was big. It's not as big as Opiongo, but that's the biggest lake in the park. This is a very, very close second though, I think. And it goes way back in there and tucks back in that way, and that's the way we have to go tomorrow. Drying some clothes. Got real sweaty and wet from walking in the water a bit today. I had to bring the canoe way up there because our landing spot was non-existent.
We're just purifying some water. I got 2 liters going here. This is all the containers I brought for the trip. Two 1-liter bottles. And That seemed to do pretty good for me. I can have one on the go. I didn't have any when we got here because it was such a hectic end to the day and we were trying to hurry up, but did my dishes. I brought a little green scrubby. I don't know if you can see that, but to clean my titanium pot. So what I do after I eat is I'll take water and I'll boil it again on the jet boiler or whatever it is, the MSR. And let it sit, and then scrub it out with the green scrubby, toss it back in the water or in the fire pit, depending. But everything's clean. Water's good to go. That's got to sit for 20 minutes now. I'm using Pristine Drops. It's like a Canadian equivalent to Aquamira. So what I've been using for the past however long, past year.
Are you going to like come do work, or are you just going to keep running your mouth?
I just probably want to run my mouth some more.
Oh, I'm so great. Look at all this shit. Mm-hmm. It's what Kyle told me to do, but I rejected him for over a year. And I was like, screw you, man. I'm not doing that.
You should see him. He's very animated right now.
Let me just keep filming you sawing the wood.
Mm-hmm. Are you angry?
Am I?
Yeah.
No, not yet.
What will it take to make you angry?
You just sitting there doing artistic angles on your camera while I cut all this wood up?
You're out of frame.
Your face is out.
There you go. Adventure Swarm Bucksaw really makes short work of this firewood. Really liking this thing.
That looks fancy. What do you got going on there?
You got ground beef, brown rice.
Move your hand so the people at home can
sorry.
See.
Sorry. You got ground beef, brown rice, black beans, cheddar cheese, butter, taco seasoning, salt, and Fritos.
Bam, son.
It's pretty good.
Cholesterol.
So the key to starting fires, it's a wad of birch bark and a Bic lighter. I know it's a little...
That's not Bushcraft!
It's a little high on the skill list, but I think you guys can handle it. Bam. It's the easy man's fire today.
Day two in the books. I think we're both happy to be here, and happy that this day went how it went. It has its challenges. Every trip has its challenges. Every day has its challenges, and I think that's what we want. We wanted to be pushed. We wanted to have an epic trip, and that's what makes it epic. The hardships and the unknown, the unforeseen. So all in all, good day. Long day, hard day. And I'm excited for tomorrow and what that tomorrow brings.
You doing your poetry over there?
Hmm?
Talking all poetry and stuff over there, all I care about is more Fritos.
Spoken like a true gentleman.
Stuff, man.
You ready for some rum or what?
Duh. Ready for a hearty ration of spirits right about now. I can't hear you over the sound of Fritos.
Nice pink sky, red sky at night, sailor's delight. What's the rest, Kyle?
I don't know. Your saying is dumb.
It's not my saying. It's a nautical saying.
It's a Canadian saying.
It's not a Canadian saying.
It's got to be a Canadian saying.
It's a nautical saying.
Whatever it is dumb.
It will save you from certain nautical disaster.
I don't know. Maybe you're paddling. I don't think that's possible.
What does paddling mean? Oh, yeah. Good times.
Drink some more and shut up.
Good times.
What was your favorite part of the day, Kyle?
Drinking the booze.
Really?
That and the Fritos.
Fritos and booze. Well,
I think... In reality, I don't know, we saw the mink. That was kind of cool. That was something different.
I think you catching that walleye was pretty cool.
I forgot about that. I felt like it was 3 days ago.
I know it does. I know.
I felt like it was 3 days ago. I didn't even remember that. See, no, walleye for sure. That was cool.
It was a really pretty fish. Hopefully she got some teeth. No? You don't get it? Hobie Trace? Real name, no gimmick? Nope. Alright then. We have a nice overcast day. Some fog on the lake. It's still really early. Nobody's up on the lake. You can tell because there's not motorboats and people screaming and dogs barking. But really nice morning. It was hot and muggy last night. Really, really hot. Swept my heart out. So oatmeal time. So when I was preparing for this trip, I dehydrated some fruit and I tried these bananas and I'm really not a fan of them too much. So I think I'm gonna throw some in my oatmeal with my raisins and have them rehydrate in there with the water and the oatmeal. And I think I will enjoy them more that way. I'm gonna do it right inside this plastic bag. I've done it before with no issues. And someone told me that there's no BPA in Ziplocs, so hopefully they're right. If not, no big deal. Oh yeah, oatmeal soup today. I'm gonna close it up and let it sit and try and thicken up because I put way too much water just now. Weak.
You think after all these times you've done that you'd get it?
Yeah, it doesn't. I just keep repeating the same mistakes over and over in life.
You should poke a hole in with your spork.
It's too early. Too early. The bananas in the oatmeal was good, and the extra water was good because by the time I ate it, it thickened right up and it was a good consistency. So all is well in the food department. Today we have 4,500 meters of portage on top of however many meters of paddling. 4,500 meters of portage is like 4.5 kilometers of portaging. One is 3,000 meters by itself. So I think the most I've ever done it once before is 3,000. And then we have another 1,500 on top. So that's a lot of work today. We're gonna probably get packed up here real quick and head on out because it's nice to paddle on the lakes before the sun comes out and stuff. Maybe the sun won't come out too much today because it's overcast, but it's still nice to get on the lake early.
That was pretty funny.
What is that in the water?
I threw the map in the water.
You're just done.
Quick rinse of cleaning.
You're just done with this trip.
Drop the water.
In the boat again. Going places that we've already been. We're paddling back that way again. Because Kyle can't read that map, no.
Oh, it's my fault for the map, huh?
Who told us that we had to go that way yesterday?
Well, I did not have in my possession secondary map.
Excuses. So, this is for Lake Kiosk. Hopefully never to return again. I think we decided on future trips, no more camping on access lakes. It's fine to paddle through them, no big deal. But
just it's a holiday, it probably doesn't help.
It's just not our style, our kind of thing. So we are off to the interior of the park, and by maybe tomorrow we'll be on a nice river. We're not gonna see many people anymore and stuff. It'll be, what day is it today, Sunday? I think it's Sunday. I think it's Sunday today, so I think most people will be leaving anyways. And where we're going, there's 4,500 meters of portage, so not too many people will be going there, hopefully. That's what we think.
Look, it's Canadian Air Force.
Bald eagle. Cool. It's a huge log jam here. All this driftwood. Looks pretty cool. We've got a beaver slide that's been used really recently. It's got to be a beaver dam here. They packed all that mud there. And you can see that's a slide. They go into the water. And actually, there's an indent in the water. Very beavery around here. Am I not beavery enough for the beaver club? Beaver.
our way to the portage here. It's a little shallow. Joe, I'm slowing you down immensely.
Okay. Yeah, pull me, Sherpa.
We just completed two different portages. I think I stopped filming after I single carried the one over to a mobile de fond, which is a river. And we just had a little short, we had to actually walk through the river and pull the canoe through it on our last one because it was like 3 inches of water. But Kyle's carrying the canoe this time. And we got to get back into Mobile de Fond River. And we are actually paddling upstream for a while. It's gonna be a little bit challenging. I can see the current right now and it's substantial. So got to do that for a while and then on to a big lake again. So doing good.
Rapid! This will be our first substantial portage from Mobile du Fond to Manitou Lake. And I'm not sure if you can pick that up, but it's 1,355 meters.
Mobile du Fond River was very nice. I liked it. There's a sweet campsite by some rapids. And I think that you could catch some trout at the end of it, but it's a little bit too late in the day and we're kind of on the move, so we're not going to fish right now. We'll fish tonight. I'm going to get a little bit of food in me before this portage.
It's called numbers. It's 1300.
Stop. We just completed the 1300 meter portage and halfway through it started raining. So we got here and we are on some big water. This is Manitou Lake. So we've got about 7 or 8 kilometers to do on this big lake and it's real windy and the wind's coming at us. So we're going to stop and have lunch right now. So for lunch, I'm doing flatbread with German salami and I'm cutting up some baby bell and putting that on there. And I had every intention in the world, actually we did do it, we went to Wendy's on the way here for lunch. And like a week before I was at Wendy's and I was able to get a bunch of packs of mustard for my chicken strips. So I was like, yeah, I like mustard on my sandwich, we'll stop at Wendy's and I'll even buy if I have to, a bunch of mustard packets. Well, we get to Wendy's and they no longer have mustard packets. So Wendy's, step up your damn game and bring back the mustard packets. Today we started at kiosk about here, paddled across, little portage, did the Mobile du Fond River, and then that big portage. And we're here at the ass end of the portage. And we've got to go down through there and then a 3,000 meter portage. The lake is very rough. We've got to go right into it, so I'm not looking forward to it. I really don't like doing these big lakes for this reason, but this is what we signed up for. This is what we wanted, so in order to get where we want to go, this is what we have to do. So have at her. Well, considering we're going on this lake and there's big waves and whatnot, I'm gonna put the DSLR away. I've had it out the whole time, but I'm gonna strap the GoPro on my head mount and get some footage that way because I really don't want my camera getting wet. And possibility of tipping in here is greater. It's not gonna happen, but it's greater than out there in the smaller lakes, so better safe than sorry.
That's not so bad. I know. It's friggin' Lake Erie, bro. Correct, yes. It's not too bad. I'm straight at us. So we were lucky enough to round a bend and finally after 2 hours of paddling have the wind at our backs. And I think up in front of Kyle somewhere is our portage, the start of the portage. And then we'll have to do 3,000 meters and then we can camp on the next lake, which will be Three Mile Lake. We just passed a couple canoeists and they said that Three Mile Lake is a nice lake. So we're both looking real forward to that. This has been a pretty tiresome paddle, to be honest. We've been on the same lake for over 2 hours, like I was saying, so it'll be nice to take a break, and by break I mean portage a lot. The long-awaited portage is just in front of us. I can see the yellow sign finally.
We are super pumped to be here. Yay! Okay, are you gonna get out or are you just gonna keep singing? I have a look of disapproval on my face. I'm just gonna get out. I'm just gonna get out.
No.
Yep, I'm getting out. Don't pull it. Oh yeah. Oh, my ankles.
Ankles?
My ankles. Yeah, it's uphill. So I'm headed back down to the canoe. We left it there and just brought our packs to the top of this hill. This is an intense hill right off the hop, and there's no way either of us are gonna carry our pack and the canoe at the same time up this thing. So me and Kyle made a deal where I'm going to go back and get the canoe and bring it back up this very rocky and crazy hill, and then he's gonna single carry with his pack in the canoe for a while up on the flat ground. So that seems like a good deal to me. I can handle that. I'm headed down to grab her right now. So I've got about 500 meters to go up this hill before I meet up with Kyle. And I'm already huffing and puffing. This canoe weighs 45 pounds. It's not the heaviest in the world. It's actually pretty light. And there's no way I would be wanting to do this with a 70-pound canoe. I physically couldn't do it.
We're almost there, Joe.
It's done. The big old long portage is done for the day. All we have to do now is get to our site. So I'm ready to do that and hopefully get some fishing done tonight.
Well, we're done for the day. We found a nice spot on the 3 mile lake. It's nice and flat. Kyle's already all set up, blowing up his pad. I've just been kind of sitting here because I'm pooped. I'm plum tuckered, as it were. And I want to make up some food because I'm really hungry. So for dinner tonight, I've got quinoa with chicken and mushrooms, green pepper, red pepper, and onion, I believe. So this is what it looks like beforehand, dehydrated. Here's our camp. Got a lineup, trying some socks, and sleeping bag, pillow, all that fun stuff. Fire pit over there. My sleeping bag just fell. It's real windy, but that's good. It's not cold at all, and the wind is a welcome relief. So I set my tent up with the wind coming right at it inside the screen so that it'll dry it out. This is the tent I've been using for the better part of a year. And it's the big Agnes Fly Creek UL1. I love it. I don't think I'll get another tent until this one's obsolete. So, yeah. So here she is, all done. My quinoa chicken mix. And it's about 1.5 meals. And I need it today because I'm starving, so I'm going to mow this down real good while Kyle goes and cuts some firewood, and then we'll switch off. He can eat and I'll go get some firewood. Firewood duty. Up and out of that wind for a little bit. Got to try to find some good firewood. It's a very coniferous area where we are, and Kyle said there might have been some maple he saw up to the right over here, so I'm gonna check her out. I think I found a little bit of wood. It's not the greatest, but beggars can't be choosers. So I'm going to chop up that down piece of probably maple. I don't want to get hung up on anything. Oh yeah, that's solid. So much work filming these walking away scenes. I hope you guys appreciate it. Here, I bring the wood, Kyle.
Oh, why?
Yes. Those are some nice shorts, Kyle.
A little bit of sunburn there, right? Mm-hmm. Can you rub the lotion on it later?
I'm gonna put that in the video.
The lotion?
It puts the lotion in the video, or else it passes camp with Kyle again. So, like I said, I found some maple, was able to find a couple pieces of hardwood, and there's all this scrub, pine, and whatnot that people left over from other campers, so that's probably good for tonight. We got some balsa fir. This balsa fir, like I said the other day, yesterday maybe, does not split for anything, so anyways, we're good for wood. Look at all the gnats above my tent.
Yasser Arafat.
Yasser Arafat, he says. We're losing our minds, I think. That's a lot of gnats there, brah. Gnarly.
A bam, son.
Wow, first throw. Get all tangled up here.
Oh.
Yeah, that worked. That's cool. When does the bag come down? Wow, that's strange. Did you put any weight in there? There's paracord in it.
Oh, okay.
Take two. All right. Trust again. Ready?
Yep.
A bam, son! Whoa! First try! Way to go! Not too bad.
That was good. First thing you ever sucked at all day.
Yeah, on point. On point, son. On fleek. This guy over here.
I know when.
You're probably golden right there, bud. Yeah, I'd say that's good. We going fishing. Well, we got skunked fishing, we're back now, but no big deal. It was a super nice night. I'm really glad we went out and paddled. Really cool colors in the sky. I got some footage on my GoPro, and hopefully it turns out, but it probably won't do justice. But we got off the water just as the wind kicked up. Now we're gonna have a fire.
And the nature is better when you don't know.
There we go.
Birch bark fire.
Guten Tag.
Guten Tag.
it was calm for, I don't know, a good 2 hours. Now it's, it seems like a storm's a-brewing. Now we're just kind of relaxing by the fire. But to get into the sailor jerry, I think. What are you saying?
That's fine, sounds good to me. See what we have for mix tonight. Fruit punch. Cherries, blueberries, and oranges.
Mmm.
It's good stuff.
Oh. Should have seen all that. Should have seen all
that. It's all the candy bars I ate today.
How many candy bars did you eat today?
At least 7. Maybe 8. That's a lot.
Oh my gosh.
Somebody needs a lot of energy to portage your canoe.
Okay, that was cruel. Cruel in it.
Story, bro.
I'm gonna drink now.
Liberally applying a mixture of bear's grease and skunk oil.
Excerpts from the Voyager film.
We are... Did you record that?
Oh yeah.
Great. We are canoe nerds now.
What is that film called?
It's National Film Board of Canada. Voyagers.
Of course.
Yes, I know. Canada's the best at everything. Mm-hmm.
Pretty good. So is this granola bar. You know? You know?
No, I'm fixing your axe that I dirted. That's what I'm doing.
Are you dirted?
I dirted the fucker.
You Tyler dirted him?
Like right off the side. Is it frickin' balsam fir? It's the devil. I hate that wood. It's terrible. It's the only thing we're burning, though.
Tell me more.
Well, it's knotty. It doesn't want to split. It's got sap all over your frickin' hatchet.
Hatchet?
Hatchet. It's like an axe and a hatchet put together.
You are all agitated right now.
I am agitated. You know, oh, look what I just did to my leg.
Okay, well, look. Let's show the folks at home.
Steel mixed with sunburn.
America.
Yeah, that's what you say every other 3 seconds whenever I say anything. Oh, wow, that's straight America. You said you're hungry? America. You need booze? America. Portage America.
Do you have any extra booze, actually?
No, you're not getting my extra booze.
What happened?
I told you to buy more booze. We walked in the store. I'm like, Joe, how much booze do you have? Like, oh, I have enough. I'm like, are you sure? Because I feel like you're going to want to steal mine at, like, day 4. Sure enough, day 3. Oh, okay, yeah, let's go ahead and steal Joe's booze. Or Kyle's booze. Or whoever I am and you are.
We're having fun. Yep.
They hate us because they hate us.
Dolly sods.
Dolly sods.
Alright.
Dolly sods, Dolly sods. I was going to do this trip solo.
Say it again?
If I was going to do this trip solo, I would bring a small, tiny pocket knife.
That's what I did.
Gransfer's outdoor axe, because I like that one. And that saw, that adventure saw. I like that quite a bit.
It'd be a good combo.
It is. I like the little tiny hatchet.
Yep, and like...
I'm not a big knife guy. Really, I'm not. I'm a hatchet person. Sandvik of Sweden.
Yeah, I think we could have got away without the axe, but really, it's fun to use.
This is pretty light.
Yeah, it's not too bad.
It's dull as crap before I touched it, but that's...
Before or after you put it in the dirt?
Well, the dirt sharpened it.
Mm-hmm.
It's like a micro...
As it does.
It's a micro, derma thing.
Micro dermabrasion?
Yeah, going on with the axe.
That's...
It's advanced, I know. It's difficult for you to
understand. It's very difficult for me to understand. You're right.
A lot of times you say I'm difficult to understand. Remember when we were in the wind today and you were yelling at me about, where do we go? Where do we go? Like that, really loudly.
I don't recall that, actually.
You don't? Do I go to the left or the right of the island?
Mm-hmm. That was a lot of wind, and I didn't want to go the wrong way.
It wasn't bad. It wasn't cold. We weren't going to flip.
You're right.
I had my life jacket on. You didn't because you're riding dirty or whatever you do.
No, can't put that in the video now. Well, that's it for tonight. We had a nice long day.
What?
Talking to the camera. Nice and rewarding. It's funny, we try to look back on things that happened today and it seems like it happened a long time ago. At day 4 up tomorrow, and we're going to get up early and go fishing. Try to be out of here by 7 or 7:30 at the latest. We have like a 1500 meter portage, something along those lines. And then we're into some small lakes, so hopefully we'll be able to catch some fish there. We tried trolling tonight, and it was to no avail. Good night, guys. Meh. I'm awake again. Thanks to Kyle. Banging on pots and pans, screaming at me like a voyageur. It's choppy. The water's real choppy. The wind is crazy. Last night I was kind of concerned stuff was going to fall down on us. There were some really strong gusts, and we're pretty exposed here. But all is well. We've got to get up and get a move on. Hopefully smaller lakes aren't so choppy and can actually get some fishing going down. We got a pretty good day today, pretty easy day compared to yesterday, so we're looking forward to fishing. I'm getting tired of that guy over there, but what are you gonna do? Oh, we're just trying to get packed up real quick and go, so I'm not taking time to eat oatmeal for breakfast. Got some of that pink drink, and what I'm eating for breakfast is last weekend I had a course, our bushcraft school, Northgate Bushcraft, had a basic bushcraft course. We had a very nice lady, Stephanie, that came, and she made us these bars. I'm not really sure what to call them, but except for Stephanie's amazing Wonder Energy bars, there's like full of puffed millet, pistachios, all sorts of stuff, and they're held together with peanut butter and something else. She did them really healthy, and they're super filling and awesome. So Stephanie, if you are watching, thank you so much. This is the last one, and this is breakfast for me. Very good. Both have the same rods. You got them off Amazon. $20 or something?
$25, the Proton.
Proton? It's telescopic, and it's pretty beefy. It's been doing all right. If I could catch a fish, it'd be a little bit better. But I'm not going to fault the rod for that.
It's great because they fit right in the portage packs. You don't have to actually carry them extra.
Yep, agreed. So, throw the reel on, which I left in my backpack, and now I have to dig through my stuff again. Fantastic!
Retake.
We're getting kind of skunked here. Kyle just caught a little pumpkin seed, which is half the size of a normal one, but it's a good morning. We're gonna
two, three good bites of food.
Oh yeah, we're gonna keep trying. It's rough fishing here. The second day we caught a couple each, and ever since then, mind you, we haven't fished a lot, but ever since then it's been no go. But our plan is to fish this lake for a little while, then we got like a kilometer portage into a bigger lake, and I think that's it for fishing until nighttime today. #skunked. Another one of these lakes, eh? We're on Bigger Lake. This will be our campsite lake for tonight. Well, we stopped here on Bigger Lake, not at our campsite, at the first campsite we could get to, because paddle over was a little treacherous and we are beat. Honestly, we've been going hard for three and a half days basically. So I think today we already ate here, rested up, filled up on water and all that. We're just going to go on to a campsite down the lane, not too far from here, and I think that's it for today. I'm gonna relax and maybe even take a nap. It's only what, 12 or something like that, and then tonight we can fish and stuff. So it's a good little campsite to stop at and refuel, but that's it. Look at the size of this spike I found. It's like a roofing nail or something like that. I think it's one of the ones that they use to tie to make the sissy bars on the portage so you can hang your canoe or rest your canoe there. That's a beast, man. I kicked it thinking it was a stick. Big Agnes. I love this ten.
freestanding tents, y'all. So for the past little while, I've been using trail runners. I've been using my Montrails, and they're almost done. So for this trip, in preparation, I bought these New Balance Minimus trail runners, and they're doing really well. I like them a lot. They're super lightweight. They've been able to dry easy by the fire every night. The grip on them is awesome. You don't really need ankle support, in my opinion. Your ankles are supposed to move back and forth. So these are good. Good to go, in my book. Everything's all squared away now. We were just lounging around, and decided to go for a swim. So we're gonna cut some firewood beforehand because we're gonna work up a sweat and all that stuff, and then we'll stop and have a swim, cool down.
Swimming time.
Woo! It's so cold, yeah! It's fantastic, dude! I can still touch the ground over here, it's all sand. Yeah, it's pretty awesome, actually.
This lake is awesome to swim in. I'm into my neck, about, I don't know, 20 yards away from the shore, and I'm standing on sand. There's a great view behind me, not too cold.
I think we both feel rejuvenated now. Had a nice swim, kind of relaxing. It's a nice break. Tomorrow we got a lot of hard work ahead of us, so it's nice to have this day. Just kind of take off, enjoy the natures. We did a pretty good job of setting up this tarp, I think. Nice and high up and lots of protection. Camp's looking nice. Everything's really good today.
Thanks.
What are you doing, Kyle?
Making sure that I have enough food to survive the rest of the time with you.
Uh-huh.
Because if I have to put up with you and not eat at the same time, I'm going to die.
Yeah. Just out here checking the sun. There's still about an hour left. But there's already some cool colors, so I imagine tonight will be nice. Today we didn't see anyone, which we thought was going to happen. It's Monday now. Labor Day weekend's over, and we're in farther into the interior than I've ever been. So nothing to do left tonight. We're not going to go fishing. It's too choppy. The lake's too big. No big deal. We'll hit that up the next couple days. But all we're going to do is just hang out by the fire now tonight.
You're so great.
You're the best bushcraft ever. Why'd you use your saw blister at all?
I didn't want to gouge it. It's a new fire still. How's that for a sunset? The whole lake is pink. The sky's pink. It's calmed down. Very cool. Day four is done now. It was a really nice day, really nice night. We sat out on the rocks and watched the sun go down, and then later on we came out and watched the stars. And the sky is full of stars right now. It's nice and clear. So we're hoping that means the temperature is going to drop a little bit and be all right sleeping weather. Tomorrow we have a lot of work ahead of us, pulling upstream and probably pulling the canoe. But we're looking forward to it. Today was a nice relaxing day, and tomorrow we're back to the grind. So we got 3 full days left and then a half a day after that. Good night, guys.
Joe, he whines a lot. That's what you don't see. So guys, here's what you don't see on camera. Here's the behind the scenes. I'll give you the full lowdown on Joe. Is the kid smells bad. Oh my God. You walk behind him. I mean, if you've ever been to like a barn, just like a horse barn that's never been cleaned, that kid. That's bad. He's always whining about, hey, I gotta go to the bathroom. Like, he'll pee. And then 15 minutes later, he has to pee again. I've babysat 4-year-olds that pee less than he does. It's just every 15 minutes he's got to pee. And then we got to go number two. And number two is a complicated thing because you got to find the right site. And he's got to look for it. He's worse than, I've taken dogs out to pool, like a small puppy. He's like a damn puppy. You got to take him out to pool all the time. See, that's bad. What else does he do? Carrying the canoe. Portage. Oh, my God. 1,000-meter portage. I do 800. He does 200. Then he's like, oh, look at me, big muscles, I'm Canadian. It's all like that. And then the worst part of camping with Joe is, you know, you get to the end of a portage, and there's a group of people there, and within 12 seconds, he's like, oh, look at me, I'm on TV, I have a channel. Just like that. And that's what he sounds like in my ears. It's, oh, look at me. And then we have to make sure we're at a big lake when we meet people, so that when he talks about himself, his head is... I'm awesome, look at me. I'm hoping when he edits the video that he finds this little clip, and it's quite a gem. I might do it a few more times too, just to screw with him. Good times.